that we might find in some particular place.
So this new education arises out of two needs. The first one is the blue economy, the idea that there's a lot of potential for engineering projects in the oceans and marine environments. And the other one, of course, is sustainability goals, that whatever we do in these environments, it has to be done responsibly and sustainably.
I think it represents a unique opportunity to get skills both in understanding the aquatic environment, but also in engineering constructions and infrastructure in such aquatic environments.
That was actually what I kind of was hoping for when I originally started at the Aquatic Science and Technology. So the new master program would actually fit me very well.
Well, there's a lot of commercial activities going on in the marine environment. Everything from shipping to building offshore structures, like for instance windmill parks, monitoring processes in the ocean, looking at sediments, coastal processes, building harbours.
Now I'm studying the physical and biological environment in East Greenland and how these two components of the system interact. For me, that's a super interesting project to study because it's a rapidly changing environment and it has this transition zone between the Arctic conditions and Atlantic conditions. For me, one of the most exciting results was to observe that there's been a change in the vertical distribution of water masses. It's a really quite dramatic and also systematic change that we've observed. And what we're seeing so far indicates that there is potential for more productivity in the region, which opens up new opportunities and possibilities for fisheries.
My PhD is about the biological pump, and the biological pump is the process where CO2 is bound into organic matter through photosynthesis into phytoplankton in the surface ocean, and then it's transported into the deep ocean. The main focus is to get the sinking velocity right. That's the crucial point in this. So it's not a way of fixing the climate change problems. It's rather a way of describing what's happening so that we can get more accurate predictions.
So here the concentration of bicarbonate ions is contributing 1:1, but the concentration of
the candidates, I hope, will come out of this with a very strong appreciation of what the oceans do and what they are, and very much tuned into the problems that are associated with it. The oceans, after all, are an enormous resource. Not simply for engineering, but also for us as human beings.